At a very basic level, plants use photosynthesis to capture the sun's energy to grow, to create what we would call fuel, but it's basically the plant parts. Fire is the flip side of that. It's from a chemical reaction, it's basically just the opposite reaction where the plants are yielding the energy that they've stored in the plant structures. What's given off by the fire is smoke. Smoke is just a natural part of combustion, but smoke is a problem. Smoke is a challenge. Smoke has impacts on human health. And part of the process of planning a prescribed burn and conducting a prescribed burn is determining where the smoke that you're producing goes. Because of the Clean Air Act, we have to manage smoke. Unlike wildfires, we don't control when wildfires occur, where they occur, where the smoke grows. But with prescribed burning, we have control over that, so we have to plan for smoke. A great deal of work is going on to understand what's in the smoke. There's also a great deal of research going on to improve our ability to predict on a given day under a given weather conditions where that smoke will go, so that managers can predict where that smoke will go, what its potential impacts might be. For instance, if there's a sensitive area downwind that you don't want smoke. And that could be a retirement home or a community. That could be a NASA facility where you've got satellites. That could be an area where you've got great visibility and that the public loves, and you don't want to mess up the visibility. Smoke is a big issue. It's a big challenge with the use of fire, because if we want to use it intentionally, we have to not only manage the fire, the fuels, the vegetation, but we also have to manage the smoke.
Thanks for watching that short. Understanding fires in the West is complicated. Keep watching this series to understand some of the other things that influence forest fires.